Hey guys, welcome in Mastering Angular 15 from Beginners to Advanced course. In today's lecture, we will see the introduction to observables. Observables are a primitive type introduced by the RxJS library used for handling asynchronous operations and events in Angular. They represent a stream of data that can emit multiple values over time and they can be cancelled. There are a few common types of observables. First is finite versus infinite observables. An observable can be finite, meaning it will complete at some point, or infinite, where it continues to emit data for an indefinite amount of time. Second is cold versus hot observables. A cold observable only starts running when subscribed to, while a hot observable produces values even before subscription. Now let's create these all types of observables in our application. If we want to create the observables by using the list of values, then we will use of. Now first let's define the of observable, and for that var of observable is equal to of, and now in brackets I will define all the random values, and here the values will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now if we want to fetch these values, then we will subscribe this of observable. Now the primary purpose of using these observable is to be listened or observed for the future events. So listening to these events is done by calling the subscribe function of the observable so that we can access the value that is being emitted. Now I'm going to write these values in console.log. Now what it will do, it will print all the values from 1 to 6 on the console.log. So it's a cold observable because we can't get its values until we subscribe it. Next we have is from observable. RxJS operator from is very similar to the operator of. It also converts the arguments to an observable, but the main difference is this operator can only take one argument. So we can only pass in this array of values, but not the values directly. We can fetch the values in from observable exactly like we were accessing by using of observable. We will subscribe this from observable and write all the values of the arrays in console.log. Normally we used to write these observable in services so that we can share these values throughout the application. But right now, for the sake of understanding, we are writing this code in component. So these both observables from and of lie in cold and finite observables. If we want to create a hot observable, then we have an option of subject var subject observable. Observable we can also indicate by dollar sign. If we write dollar sign at the end, it means we are initializing an observable here. So we have initialized here subject type observable. Now in subject observable, we can't pass the value at the time of creation. So now we will write subject dollar dot next, and in this I'm going to pass this value 23. A subject is a special type of observable that allows values to be multicast to many observers. Now subject dot next is sending the value 23 to all the subscribers of the subject. It's pushing the value down the stream, and any part of our application that subscribe to that subject will receive this value. Now subject is a hot observable because when it emits a value using the next method, that value is pushed to all its subscribers immediately, regardless of when they subscribed. Now if we subscribe it, it will not get 23 value because we subscribe it after the execution of next function. This is because in case of subject, once a value is emitted, any late subscribers won't receive that value. This is different from a cold observable, where the data producing mechanism starts fresh for each subscriber. Now if I want to pass a value to this observable, then I will call this next function after the subscribe function. So subject.next, and here I'm going to pass value 24. And after this, let's pass another value 25 here. Now subject doesn't require an initial value when we instantiate it. But there is a behavior subject that requires an initial value. When a new subscriber subscribes to a behavior subject, it will immediately receive the current value. Also in case of subject, it will not replay the latest emitted value to new subscribers. When we subscribe to a regular subject, we only get values that are emitted after the subscription. But in case of behavior subject, it automatically replays the last emitted value to new subscribers. Now let's write behavior subject. Var b subject is equal behavior subject. In behavior subject, I can pass the value at the time of creation. Now if I subscribe this behavior subject, then it will not miss any value before it. So it will not miss this 26 value. Now after subscribe function, I'm going to again call the next function for this observable, and let's pass value 27 here. So these are the common observables we use in our services. Now let's run the application and see these observables in the console.log. As you can see, it prints all the values of off observable first, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then it prints the array of from observable in which we have value 7, 8, 9. Then as you can see, it missed the value 23 because we call this next function before the subscribe of subject observable. After 24 and 25, we subscribe behavior subject. Behavior subject didn't miss any value, so it prints 26, 27, both the values. Hope you understand this basic difference between all these observables. Now if we compare these observables with promises, then first we talk about multiple values. Observables can emit multiple values over time, while a promise can only resolve or reject once. Then there is a lazy execution. Observables are lazy. For example, they don't start emitting values until someone subscribes to them. Promises are eager and will start executing immediately after they are defined. Then third is cancelable. Observables can be cancelled using the unsubscribe method, while promises can't be cancelled. So observables clearly offer more advantages than promises. Observables can handle multiple asynchronous operations more elegantly than promises and callbacks. Observables support cancelable asynchronous operations. With RxJS operators, we can compose asynchronous code in a more readable and maintainable way. Now if we talk about the cons of the observables, then observables come with a learning curve and can be hard to understand, especially for beginners. Debugging can be challenging due to its asynchronous nature. If not properly managed, observables can lead to the memory leak. So this was the today's lecture. Hope you understand it. If you still have any question or query, you can ask in comments. But guys, if this lecture is helpful for you, then please like, subscribe, and share my channel. Thanks for watching.